Fare thee well, fair Valyard. You were a charming, witty, clever, fun-to-be-around type who was a blast at parties and really knew how to destroy ponies with their own flaws. You will be missed. Discord put a paw over his black hole of a heart, speaking to a tiny picture of the Valyard with a black ribbon. He wiped away a non-existent tear.
Good riddance to bad rubbish,
Andrew Pye said, meaning every word. I didn't like his attitude, but at least he knew how to have fun, Flutterquill said. I had the biggest passions I've ever encountered, Rancor said, with a straight face. It was a real shame he had to go. But for the greater cause, sacrifices must be made. Discord's two living purple plastic music box ponies mined weeping tears since they didn't have tear ducts. The dirt meat also wept politely, one of them playing funeral dirge on a kazoo. Well, he's not getting any deader. Discord flipped the picture over.
My little pony, I wondered what friendship could be until you showed me the magic it brings. Little pony, I'll save this world from the dark so our hearts can sing. When I was young, my friends were always by my side, and I knew that even if we fell, it would all be alright. When chaos struck, the bonds we tied began to fray, and the friendships we'd forged faded further day by day. Then I heard your voice singing loud and clear, and it reminded me that my friends are always near. So if Discord thinks that he can break our hearts again, I'll show him the power that lies within my friends. Kindness, loyalty, and after all this teach and love, our city and the magic in me will break the chains that trap us down in the dark and burst into the light. No matter what comes, I know that we'll find a way, so we'll fight onward, seeking a bright new
Discord turned around happily, clasping his hands. Well, Traitor Dash failed me again, and that stupid Time Lord has gotten his doctorate back for good. And Tragedy and her minions are being unfashionably late to the party I've invited them to. Such rudeness. So, every Equus ready for round three? So, who fights next? Rancor asked casually. Discord grinned. All three of you. Three looked at him, surprised. Discord looked thoughtful. Six against four. Odds are too even for my tastes. Flutterquill, call upon the catering service. Flutterquill produced a remote control and pressed a button, causing the wall to raise up dramatically, revealing pony skeletons and intimidating bad flank outfits sitting around a suitably ominous table, labeled Daemonis Ex Machina, League of Auxiliary Minions. Discord tapped his chin. I could have sworn I made them all ageously immortal. Flutterquill face-hoofed. But thirsty, psychotic ponies still need air, master! I'd recommend reanimating the corpses. Then again, there's that one fool in their ranks who has a way with logic, Rancor noted. They were all B-listeds anyway. Discord rubbed the back of his head. Suppose that's why I can never keep my goldfish alive.
This is why I never let any of my fools join that stupid club, Angry Pie said.
Discord's eyes focused on Angry Pie.
Let's have a chat just between us, my pretty.
She vanished.
Hey, what about me?
Flutterquill shouted. She pouted.
I honestly don't know what he sees her,
Rancor said, as your Auntie Pandora would say, to embrace the intangible, look into the eyes of the blind.
What?
He's a fire trying to hug kindling.
Enough with the metaphors!
You'll get it when you're more mature.
You don't know me.
And talk to me.
Huh?
Tell me about yourself, niece. I read up on Dissy, but I didn't read up on you. Tell me your life from your point of view.
What?
Is it so weird that I want to know about you?
No, it's just no one ever cared to listen before.
Uncertainty crossed the gray Pegasus's face, feeling like a fish out of water. Rancor patted her on the shoulder. First time for everything, and we have time to kill before the killing starts.
Oh, all right then. The first thing I ever heard was time to be cruel.
We teleported from the throne room right into my broom! I got ready to rip his throat out! No one has a right to be in here, but Discord flicked me into a wall, leaving a big circular crack. And no, I did not leave a stupid outline in a stupid cartoon! This is my room! You have no right to—
A metal plate riveted itself over my mouth. I own the world and every pony in it, so technically I have the right to be anywhere I please, my dear.
He leaned against my exercise equipment in the lair deck to help me move in. Jerk, acting like he owned the place. He picked up something from my dresser. My vision turned red as he recklessly played with it.
My, this little crystal music box. It belonged to your, what, third apprentice? Fourth?
I tore the metal plate off and leapt at him with my good rear leg.
Get your filthy claws off it, you ugly—
He slammed me down with his tail. Dark matter blocks landed on each of my hooves, crushing them and the floor underneath. I growled, trying to pull my limbs off to get free. I'd rip them off if I had to. He put Bombay's music box back on my dresser. He looked around like my room was his personal art gallery. I must admit, I'm surprised how Spartan it is in here. I was expecting walls of weapons, trophies, and is that a bed? You know you don't really need to sleep. Dreaming of the children you had to watch grow old and die. Gray walls, gray bed, how droll. My, all these toys gathering dust. This rubber chicken, for instance. It belonged to Pumpkin Cake, if I'm not mistaken.
That was it. I rammed into him like a pink comet, the dark matter block slang as he roared. My head rammed into his gut, making him stagger back a step. Jackass just smiled. How dare he?
You and my cruelty have always been my favorites.
You don't have favorites.
I beg to differ. You and I have a past, my dear Anchor Pie. It's only because of me that you exist.
Like I care.
I think you'll care about this. The sword snapped his fingers.
I startled in confusion. I felt the bones in my rear leg rearranging themselves, fitting back into place, growing the way they were meant to, tendons reconnecting, nerves growing. For the first time in over 500 years, I had 4 functional legs again.
The sword leaned in close, grinning at me. I flip-kicked him in the face with my repaired leg.
Not bad, my dear, but you kicked me in the wrong spot. I'm already missing my tooth on that side. I'll be sure to make them match next time.
The sword sighed. You wouldn't be the first.
He snapped his fingers. I couldn't stop myself from gasping when I found where we teleported next. I couldn't stop myself from shuddering. Tears slowly formed in my eyes as I took in the faint scent of old flowers and bones. I slowly looked around. There was a skylight which I stood right underneath. I didn't want them to be alone in the dark when I built it. The walls were lined with shining marble blocks. I polished them myself whenever I was in here. Each stone was engraved with a cutie mark. Each had a small mantel shelf which a few centuries old flowers lay in. Their names, the date they became my foal, and when they left me alone again, were all engraved too. The only laughter that I could trust wasn't directed at me. The only smiles I knew weren't hiding a sadistic lie. The only thing worthwhile in this selfish world that no one took seriously except when they were forced to. These victims of the selfish, mocking, laughing world who I could share just for a tiny while and make the mocking laughter just for a while stop. I could tell you each of their names, the colors of their eyes, their favorite color, their favorite cake, the different warmth their smiles each gave me. The mausoleum and skylight was meeting in a circle, my element of rage engraved on the floor. What was supposed to be the only way in was still locked. There used to be statues for each of the pony races with some weird cutie marks along the walls when I first found this room, smashing down a random wall. Apparently Princess Celestia had used it. Celestia, how many times had she pranked or laughed at her own subjects, toyed with them like they were toys, all to make her laugh at them? I hope she's conscious of the statue. I bet she doesn't think it's a laughing matter now.
Look at him go, Mom! I told you I'd be as strong as you someday, Ma. Those white bugs won't be laughing at anyone again, Mother.
It's okay, Fusebox. You can cry if you want.
Auntie Angry, don't!
What?!
Please, don't hurt her. She's my grandmother.
Fine. Don't be dumb, Pattercake. It'd never hurt you.
Bombay, don't worry. Mommy's here. You're just taking a little nap. Mommy will be here with you when you wake up. You don't need to worry.
Heart so full of brimming anger, boiling anything she lays her eyes upon. But tell me, My Little Pony, have you ever hated yourself? His dirty claw was on my shoulder. I bit it.
If you so much as touch them, I swear to everything I hate that I'll kill you! I snarled at the monster, looking him in the eyes.
The squirt waved his cracked claw. He looked angry at me.
Good. I hate that sick, selfish smirk.
The squirt breathed in deep. I asked, have you ever hated yourself? For having to watch them all die when you went on?
I hate you for that!
Is that so? You know I'm the one who woke you up to the dark side of laughter. The thought of no pony ever taking you seriously.
What do you expect? Gratitude? Forget it! Do you think I like you for that? I'm only angry that it took you for me to wake up, and that I can't make you stop laughing, you pig!
Why do you stay here, then? You don't need a little old me to punish the world, do you? You got your element of chaos and 4 good legs. You could keep punishing the world yourself. Why not just leave and let the elements of harmony wipe this smile off my face if you hate me so much?
Because they're here. And look at my fool's tombs. And I won't let you toy with the only ponies who don't deserve it. Sometimes I remember past the fog, past the beginning. All I do remember is that I hate it. I hate it. Each letter in the word hate made up of smaller words hate, hate it.
Being here, I reach further through the fog than ever before.
Parties, birthdays, parties, smiles, parties, rocks, parties, songs, parties, laughter, the big fat lie! There are ponies out here still laughing at me, still not taking me seriously, still treating everything like it's just their toy. My anger boils at the thought.
What if it could be different?
What?
Cross my heart, hope to fly, stick a cupcake in my eye, anger. I swear to havoc emperor phobias, home for infinite losers. I'll resurrect to full health and youth and curse with immortality all of your students upon the elimination of the rogue elements of chaos. I'll even give them their own private protected gobble community. Yours, all yours.
As an added bonus, I can make it like Sky Ocean, so the outside world is nothing more than a legend. Just you and your students.
He charged at the Pegasus. At the last moment, he held out a little earth pony foal, tears trickling from her eyes. I stopped, feeling calmer than I had been in decades, and spoke to her. Did someone laugh at you? She nodded unhappily. Do you want to come with me? She nodded more enthusiastically. I hugged her. Okay, but first sit and watch Auntie Pie trample the hay out of this nasty stallion who tried to bribe me with you, okay? She clapped her little hooves and laughed while I beat the tar out of the Pegasus.
I looked at each one, all their names calling to me. I gently placed my front hooves against Hound and Pumpkin's key marks. After Twilight and the rest were all dead, and you've kept your word, I'm coming for you next, I rumbled, looking over my shoulder. He smiled at that! An invisible wall came between us that I smashed into.
Discord made a toast with a gray stone chalice overfilled with chocolate milk. The base resembled a griffin's claw, while the cup was carved to look like four pony skulls facing outward in different directions, one looking enraged, one filled with sorrow, the third soullessly indifferent, and the last one consumed with madness.
Discord drank the milk from the cup, not the cup from the milk!
I look forward to it, my dear. It has been 8 billion years since I danced with some pony whose beauty was only surpassed by mine.
With a snap of Discord's fingers, I was teleported away.
When it's just you, me, and my little princess, we shall have our chaotic ever after at last. One handy-dandy finger snap, and it's bye-bye, giant ship on your shoulder, and welcome back, laughter! And my biggest, warmest welcome to my brand spanking new, unbridled, red-hot, accept-no-substitutes queen of insanity. Oh, Pinkie Pie, I knew there was a reason I spared you during the Lost Third Age.
And I've been doing my hardest to be everything I was born to be ever since, Fluttercoil finished.
Rancor patted her on the head.
You have such fervor in your brutality, Philly. I like you.
Fluttercoil looked at her in shock.
You do?
You didn't think I was one of the goody two-shoes, did you? I'm violence incarnate.
No, it's just, even Master thinks I need to learn some new tricks.
I'm not saying he's wrong, Philly, but you don't need to give up the core of who you are to do that.
I know, Dad has said that before, but Rancor smiled.
But you felt he was encroaching on your individuality and that he was trying to force you to be what he wanted you to be.
Trust me, I went through the same thing with my dad. But you gotta realize he only wants what's best for you. No matter what he says or what he does, he's only doing it because he cares about you.
Not that he'd admit it, but he likes to hide a lot of his emotions from even himself. Trust me, it's my job to know.
I guess that you already knew that, but...
But you didn't want to give ground by admitting you were wrong. You really are like him. Littergirl's eyes narrowed.
Don't push it.
Okay, that's never the right thing to say. But seriously, you two complete each other. What if something happened to him?
It's never going to happen, because no one can defeat Master. And even if they could, I wouldn't let it happen. I'd protect him to the end.
So you do care about him.
Always.
Discord and Angry Pie each entered the room, the former trailing slightly behind the latter.
Look, he's back! Rancor grinned.
Angry Pie trotted away from Discord. She didn't look at the others.
Good luck, kiddo.
Rancor kissed Cruelty on the forehead.
Hey, hey, hey!
Rancor floated next to Anger. Angry Pie didn't respond.
It's alright, I can actually hear your heart. You and Cruelty are actually alike like that.
Rancor caught the hoof.
Hey! Fluttercoil gasped. How? Her leg!
I fixed it.
Why?
Because I felt like it.
Now don't be like that, cutie.
Yes, I am taking you seriously. Seriously, Philly. Ponies taking you less seriously when you're like that. No, I'm not joking. Sheesh, I have issues. But honestly, you spread violence, so does Cruelty. You're both so passionate about it. Both of you are more than willing to commit revenge, which all happens to be things I embody. So of course I think you both are fun to be around. You just need to open up some.
Oh, almost caught me off guard with that one.
Angry Pie, here's some free advice. You need focus for all the anger. Aimless anger doesn't go anywhere. It just floats, and that's just wasteful. Daddy Discord jingled on Discord's pager.
All right, everyone, showtime!
Aren't you joining us? Rancor asked.
Hey, we're protecting Master. He's not protecting us,
Fluttercoil declared. She waited for Angry Pie to mutter coward or something to that effect, but no noise came.
Eh?
Fluttercoil looked at the Earth Pony, confused.
He's not stealing my fools for me. Not again.
Discord spoke to Fluttercoil.
Cruelty, be careful.
Don't you dare fail me, Fluttercoil.
Don't disappoint me, Fluttercoil.
Give him pony help, Cruel.
Good luck, Cruel.
Do your best, Cruelty.
Cruelty startled and nearly fell over. Rancor caught her.
What was that?
She shook her head. Didn't matter. She had traitors crush and thrust to Master to turn into red paint.
I don't need to be, Master.
She smirked at him. She startled at the look on his face. Not angry or annoyed at an order not being followed, but sad? Cruelty shook her head again. She'd show Master he had nothing to worry about. She was the only one he needed to be happy. Cruelty's ear flickered to Angry Pie. What was the mad pony muttering to herself now?
Pound cake and pumpkin cake, fuse box, bomb pie, powder cake, grenade pie, short fuse, little hex, hatchet and latchet, spring dew, morning light, stormy night, applesauce.
And for the first time in her life, Fluttercoil was, for a split moment, scared of her.
Those insane eyes, they were so focused, like when she had one of her nasty little apprentices.
Rancor, meanwhile, felt it, free murder pony's passion, her raw power, clamming like storm factors. Heat actually began to build up around the pony. Rancor approved.
So the memory spell didn't work, Applejack said. On the Valyard it didn't, Twilight replied. But it was intended for the Doctor, not the Valyard. It should have healed the Doctor's persona for when he regenerates. Probably ought to say something that the Valyard hasn't reappeared for round two, when, as a time traveler, he could literally ambush at any time, Verity observed. Killing 5 minutes ago, or indeed, 5 centuries ago. Yeah, so either the Doctor's back in business, or that cat's finally rankling at us bare lives, Spike scowled. Let's try to keep a positive outlook, shall we? Morbidness doesn't suit you, Spike, Verity said, frowning at the darkening expression on the dragon's face. Is there something wrong? Oh, nothing at all. Except that it's been 1,000 years since I first met you, Rarity, and I'm proving just as useless in battle as when I was a baby. Spike, you're being absurd, said Rarity. You've been plenty of help in battle and out, added Applejack. A giant dragon thinks he can't help. That's... Derby gave Apple Pie a look. Not funny. You've been plenty of help, Rarity insisted. Don't be so sore simply because a creep who prepares for everything came prepared to swiftly kill a dragon who could bite him in two, Twilight scolded Spike like a mother. You are a force of nature, Spike, dear, Rarity said. So I'm just dumb muscle. Don't ever say you're dumb again! He flew up to him, eye to eye. I know what it's like for every pony to think you're an idiot, to think you're special ed. I got put into those classes and missed out on learning things I should have learned. No ponies ever thought you were dumb. Me, Rarity, Applejack, we all know you're clever. So far, all I've done is take orders. How much cleverness does that take? At this point, Spike's voice started to choke up a little. And if I'm so smart, that dragon's main dart of the Valyards. How come I didn't see that coming? Twilight's face hoof. None of us saw that coming, Spike. This core prefers to toy with his victims, not kill him. We had 1,000 years of experience working against us. And if it happens again, if Fluttercold decides to take that page out of the Valyard's playbook, is there a way to protect myself? See? You thought ahead to it if a repeat happens. That's smart. Spike lowered his head, uncertainty in his eyes. Rarity said in a solemn tone, You think yourself uncreative, Spike? You think you're dim-witted? Tom, I imagine, would gravely disagree with you on that score. Part of Rarity was genuinely angry with Spike. And with that, for Spike came shame. I'm sorry, Rarity. I apologize. I really was being a complete jerk just now. Not a complete one, dear. You just need to stop selling yourself short. And you helped with the turrets. You were tearing through them like Dracozilla. Do you still have Dracozilla in this day and age? Dracozilla will never die. Spike couldn't help but laugh a bit. Rarity gave his neck a caring nuzzle. Twilight, please. You can't afford to cater to Spike's self-worth issues right now. Save it for after Discord Slain. I can't afford not to. Discord's too good at destroying others with their personal demons. One of his all-time favorite weapons. Then you should quit, walk away, and find element embodiments who don't whine and angst every 5 minutes. Are you suggesting I mail order replacement friends? Even if I could do such a thing, everyone has their share of psychological baggage. And the more impurities we hammer out now, the stronger our bond will be when we face Discord. You should remember that being able to stand on your own foreheads is not a sin. You sound like the Valyard. Just because an enemy is an enemy, does that mean he has no good ideas? All his opinions, knowledge, life experience, they automatically amount to garbage? Such an outlook strikes me as the epitome of vanity, and I think Trader Dash would agree with me on that. Twilight went cold as Dash's voice flooded back into her memory. Doesn't anyone at all, think my words worth listening to? Just once? You can't stand on your own. How do you ever expect to support your friends? Twilight had no logical retort to that. Every pony, on Spike. If we were lucky, we can force our way in from one of the upper floors. I'd teleport us there, but I'm not wasting a drop of mana. We're going to need every last bit of our strength. Wait 1 second, Verity interrupted. Much as I hate to disrupt such an exciting moment, meant to propose an alternative to storming the castle? Twilight cocked her head quizzically. Consider this. When we took out the Valyard, we deprived Discord of his most effective tracker, save for Discord himself. The 6 of us could elude the likes of Fluttercrawl and Angry Pie, or fight them if need be. There's very little if about that. Regardless, Discord wants us to come to him, to the castle. Their eyes all flickered to the red carpet. The way I see it, why play into his hands again? Castle is loaded with death traps, minions, portals to bad places. We could just not go there, wait him out. Inevitably, Discord would grow bored all cooped up in the castle of his. Maybe he'll come to us, and we fight then. Or maybe he'll go somewhere else to play, and we just find out where and ambush him. That's practical and logical, Twilight said with a thoughtful nod. But Discord will see right through it. What's to stop him from playing on one continent on Monday, then warping over to a different continent on Tuesday? How do we even keep tabs on his movements? Anticipate where he'll strike next? No matter how hard Spike flies or I teleport, we could very well be chasing Discord all around the world, until poor Apple Pie here dies of old age. So I'm sorry, Rarity, but our safest bet is to stop this, here and now, even if it means braving the castle. Rarity sighed. Oh, I wish I could say you were wrong. Don't ask us how our flight took us over Ponyville. It was Discord's capital of chaos. There was little in the way of logical about it. Yes, it was painful. Last time we were there, we were Discord's little minions, and Apple Pie had seen 3 or more of her friends die. It was also where I heard Apple Pie laugh for the first time, and Discord had spared her solely for that laugh.
my curiosity for the why of her laugh had brought about all of this. Puella, Caster, Magica, I promise I'm going to help save the world. Just you watch. Last time I was here, I saw a town full of diamonds, wanting them all, discarding everything else that value that went beyond their things. Is that where my dress shop was? It's been so long. I'm sorry, old Rarity. I think even after everything is over, I won't be able to go back to making dresses. I'm sorry. But maybe my talents can help me be an artist of a different kind. For now, I desire this nightmare to end, for my friends to be together again.
Mrs. Honeyville? Where's our house? Where's the post office? Where's Sugar Cube Corner? 1,000 years. All that time I spent going around the castle. I didn't think how much Ponyville would have changed. I knew every pony else was gone. Carrot Top, every pony. But my muffins, my new promises. Our old home isn't here anymore, and we'll make a new one.
Me and Rainbow, we sure did try our hardest to spare as many ponies as we could here, didn't we? If you really thought their lives weren't worth living, you wouldn't have tried so hard to save them. And here I am, the invisible Saint Applejack. Let's hope this saint can pull off a miracle. Father of all Alicorns, if y'all are listening, please help us. We're gonna need every bit of help we can get. Spike didn't care much for Ponyville itself. Everything that mattered about Ponyville to him was riding on his back right now.
Hey gals, check out down below. That's new.
Twilight turned around. After what had happened with the dragon's mane dart, she'd been spending the flight injecting Apple Pie, Derpy, and Spike with a number of antitoxins and antivenoms, just to be on the safe side.
What is it, Spike?
Look down. I swear we've left Crazy Town and gone to just plain Weirdsville. The others looked too. Applejack let out the first gasp.
What in tarnation?
How do all the ponies look so strange? Applepie asked.
Over half the ponies, Burghorns, Hippogriffs, and others, instead of being gray or having muted colors, were colored in painfully bright tones, grinning brightly, eyes outright sparkling.
A few changelings around looked gorged or drunk on the feast of positive emotions. That wasn't the capper. A pony with a racing key mark had an entire car, track, lights, and bleachers covering his entire flanks and legs. A pony with the painting key mark had an entire art museum on the rear half of her body. The images of the key marks weren't simply zooms to take up more space, but looked like an artist had taken the simple, straightforward design and had expanded them into several dozen key marks worth of ornamentation. A grayed-out mare whose key mark was a puzzle cube was looking at the ground, one of an endless number of ponies who had lost the will to live. She bumped into one of the grinning, bright-colored ponies, and their eyes met. Her eyes began to swirl a familiar pattern, and her colors went from gray to bright enough to hurt Owlpie's eyes. The mare grinned as her key mark became an entire puzzle pattern that covered half her body. She giggled as she obsessively and compulsively began drawing puzzle designs into the patterned dirt, and began taking apart and putting things back together, giggling happily the whole time.
It's bound to happen someday, Spike said. Discord ran out of ways to make ponies miserable, so he's seeing what it's like to make them insanely happy instead.
Rarity picked up on the tiny detail. Their eyes. They're all spinning the reverse of how ponies under Discord's geases normally do. At least they're not hurting themselves or each other, Applejack said. If those strange colors spread by looking at each other, this will spread to our family when they go to the market next? Applepie asked.
Not if we beat Discord before then, Twilight stated, with more conviction than she felt.
I hate to look a gift horse in the mouth, but why aren't we going insane by looking at them?
Rarity asked.
Elements of harmony powers? Derpy suggested. Looks for me.
Rat colors are weird looking, but I wouldn't mind having a super cutie mark like that, Dapplepie said.
It doesn't look that bad, Derpy agreed.
Did we stop to help them? AJ asked.
They're not hurting each other for now, so let's focus on our real goal, Rarity said.
Yes, let's.
Agreed, Twilight said.
My name is Twilight the Unicorn, and we're now flying towards Discord's Palace of Chaos. He didn't just remake Canterlot Castle in Canterlot City. He made his castle out of the entire mountain. Not that you could tell it this had ever been a mountain. The fortress was deceptively logical. That's to say, it looked like it could actually exist. Not that the design plan followed any rhyme or reason for more than one or two sections. Discord's choice in colors for his fortress were like everything else about him. One part garish, ugly, over the top, one part dark, depressing, and gray. I never said it made sense. I can see Applejack's castle garden from here. Maybe chaotic, but it was one of the few actually beautiful things in this horrid world. I hope it stays.
Spike, stop! Everyone, prepare for formation!
Eh? Spike raised an eyebrow as he slowed his approach. We should be close enough now. We're going to hit that house of horrors with the elements, here and now.
What?
Everyone said. That castle rearranges itself on Discord's whims, and on its own. I am not letting us get separated again by another hedge maze, so we're going to hit hard and take one of Discord's biggest advantages out of the fight. If we're lucky, it'll restore Princess Celestia too, and cure Pinkie Pie and Fluttershy, and petrify Discord. I'm done playing by his rules. Derpy meekly protested.
Won't that kind of show him that we have him? The elements, I mean?
Discord's not stupid. There's 6 of us. Dash and the Valiard identified most of us. And you can trust Discord's been monitoring our fights. He'll know I won't have come back unless I had a way to beat him. Jig is up.
Alright, Derpy sighed.
To the end, Twilight, Spike said simply.
I trust you, Halflet.
If it can save some pony without a fat, count me in, AJ added.
You'd better know what you're doing, Twilight, Rarity said lowly.
I fully approve. The look on Discord's face would be lovely.
The six ponies tapped into their inner selves, thinking about what their own personal truths meant to them, and what they all meant to Twilight. The symbols of harmony appeared on the heroes, and the rainbow of light formed from them. The love and tolerance death ray came crashing down. The castle stones gave a giant groan, a muffled, panicked scream. The castle grew legs and hustled out of the way of the beam of harmony, leaving a scorch mark of normal brown dirt in its place amidst the surrounding checkerboard pattern.
Now that's not fair! Derpy shouted first. Oh no you don't! Fire too!
The castle skidded backward, trembling in fear.
Wah!
Cruelty fell on her face.
My good china! Discord cried out.
This may look funny, but it's not,
Angry grumbled, upside down on her head. Anyone catch the number of that bus? Rancor shook her pounding head from the stone block that fell on her. Discord floated up.
Seriously, this castle needs to dodge much more gracefully.
I think I overpaid for this dump. His collection of record players, turntables, and 8-tracks fell over and buried him. He excavated himself.
Where were we? Screwball, Matt Tiara, Uncle needs you.
Who, Master?
Cruelty looked confused.
Don't be rude, Cruelty. You know Screwball and Matt Tiara. You're... Oh, right, I guess you wouldn't.
Master, are you feeling all right?
Of course I am. Let me guess, you hope to die in that too? Spike asked. Nope, Twilight answered. Birdie said quickly,
Twilight, we can't keep firing the rainbow of light all day. It's a serious drain on our magic reserves.
It's scared, Applejack whispered.
Cass is scared.
You're joking, Twilight and Spike said together.
No, I'm not. It... Applejack remembered little fairy ponies. It doesn't want to die.
It's a castle! It's made out of stone and brick! How can it be afraid to die when it's not even...
Birdie glared at Twilight darkly, followed by Derpy.
You're right.
Twa, spell me with that royal shout magic, Applejack said. Royal Canterlot voice.
Whatever, just enchant me.
Twilight did so.
Had a chaos castle!
She isn't really, Twilight whispered.
She is, Rarity answered.
Greetings and how do you do, good chaos castle. It is nice to see you again. How thoughtful that you kept my little garden safe for me,
Abigail Jacqueline said in tones as polite and formal as when she let herself go alone with Rarigrade.
I am terribly sorry we have returned under these dreadful circumstances, darling. Your decor is as spontaneous and expressive as ever, but we seem to be at an impasse. I presume you do not wish to keep ducking and dodging, and we do not wish to keep firing rainbows at you. I do deeply apologize for all our inconsiderate, uncalled-for behavior. Twilight in particular showed no consideration for your feelings on the matter, and I apologize for her.
Apologize for me? Ow!
Applejack kicked her.
I hope we are able to move on. I am certain you are an upright, intelligent, reasonable, and rational castle who makes good decisions. But darling, I fear we must share some very harsh words with your master. Now, I'm certain you have a vested interest in these affairs, but you should realize your master cares not a whit for you. He would just as likely blow you up if you found another place to live. If you would but let us through and not take sides, act as a neutral non-combatant, we promise to hold no grudge against you. And should we prove victorious in our endeavor, we'll have the maid switch duties from dirtying you to cleaning you instead. And you shall have two new owners who genuinely care about all life, including yours. Now, doesn't that sound positively smashing? This arrangement is to your liking and agreement. Please think of me as well on it, darling.
Two of the castle towers, one containing Cruelty's collection of kicked puppies, and the other one millions of pounds of hearth-warming fruitcake from Pony Thulu, then lined with the Pinky Promise, using one of the windows as the eye. Abigail turned back to Twilight and said,
There, darling, that should, that ought to do it, partner.
Twilight brought her hose to her ringing ears.
Oops.
Let me just fix that.
Twilight removed the enchantment. Apple Pie stared at Applejack, her eyes huge.
Saint Abigail, Applejack, which one is the real ya?
One who is your family and your friend, darling. She kissed her on the nose. Done hiding? Rarity asked calmly. I wasn't hiding nothing. Rarity made a laugh like a sleigh bell.
Liar.